Hoima District LC5 seat fell vacant after the death of the former chairman in a road accident along the Hoima-Kampala Highway.
The time frame for filling this vacancy is 6 months. And the 6 months end on 16th September this year. And that's why we have come here to launch the program, which we have already approved.
According to the Hoima District Returning Officer, Merab Kasande Asimwe, and the Albertine Region Election Officer, Emmanuel Matsiko, Electoral Commission is already prepared to handle the election process.
We have this roadmap they are going to launch today. We have so far organized this consultative meeting successfully. We have recruited all the parish and sub-county supervisors, and some of them are already here.
Received kits for updates that we are commencing with very soon, a few days from now, from Chivare, from Masindi, and other districts of Yam.
Candidates and electorates have been advised to avoid violence during the process.
Put your houses in order, follow your constitutions and your processes, because when you have problems in the political parties, those problems necessarily spill over to the elections. So I want to appeal to all stakeholders who are responsible for carrying out these elections to do their part.
The Uganda Electoral Commission Chairman, Justice Simon Byabakama, has issued serious guidelines to follow during the elections. Justice Byabakama has also discouraged political processions that are always witnessed during campaigns.
We want also to appeal to political parties and the prospective candidates to call upon their supporters to observe law and order, transparency and fairness, aimed at having a peaceful, free and fair credible elections without any violence. Please, we must desist. We must say no to violence.
However, some of the political actors in the district, especially those on the opposition side, have decried the participation of security personnel in the elections.
About the roles of these people, about protecting, no, these are things that happen. Where some, because they move with army, they move with army men, who come and take over polling stations. They tick all the ballots on the polling station. Even when you try to raise an alarm, there is no response.
We have seen during the polling day, members of political parties commanding police and army on polling days to do things in their interest.
Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.